stuck here. The cops won't bother me. Hey guys, welcome back. I wanted to talk to you guys about the Nc700 and the Cb500. I know that a lot of people look at those two bikes and they think they're very similar, but it couldn't be further from the truth. And the thing is, they're both great bikes, and I've had those same bikes, and I really like them. I think I like the NC quite a bit just because of its quirkiness nature, and it's extremely handy for everyday riding. And in a way, I do regret selling mine. But I wanted to make a video, maybe, you know, comparing and contrasting these two bikes, because I think a lot of new riders getting into the sport of riding and want to get the ADV bikes, they're probably looking at the CB500, but the Nc700 is an extremely good bike that also should be looked at. And I'm not going to compare it too much to the V-Strom 650 or to the Tenray, because they're very different bikes, but those two are really good deals in the used marketplace. So let's get started. So the Nc700X, you can get it from like 2012, and that's the year that I got, 2012. At a certain point, the Nc700 had an update, which was an Nc750. And that's a lot harder to get in the United States, and it's more expensive, and it looks very different. The update also includes the dash, and the CB500 is mostly unchanged until recently, when they added a 19-inch front wheel. The one I had 17-inch wheels, and it's much more in a direct comparison to the NC. So to get started, the NC and the CB both have 17-inch wheels, unless you get the later version of the CB with the 19-inch wheels, which puts it in a different category. It puts it more in competition with the V-Strom 650. This one, it's got a 19-inch front wheel, and the reason you want a 19-inch front wheel or bigger wheel is that it's going to roll over terrain better. Like if you're riding off-road and you hit a rock, it's much more stable having a larger wheel. That's why dirt bikes have 21-inch front wheels. It makes the rotation of bikes much better. The CB500 is actually a 471cc bike. Both of these bikes are two cylinders, inline two, parallel twins, or whatever you want to call it. And they're both very reliable. And I would actually give the reliability to the Nc700X. All the things I've read online, the Nc700X is much more popular in South America and Europe than it is in the United States. And the reason I give it reliability, like a better reliability record, is that there's many more people with over 150,000 miles with it. And also, because the Nc700's engine revs so low that it's a very understressed engine as opposed to the CB500. The biggest difference that you're going to find in both of these bikes is the engine. The CB500 is a much more classical or standard motorcycle engine. It revs much higher. It's got a very like revvy feeling. And that's what most motorcycle riders like. The NC, it actually feels more like a scooter engine. It's very low revving, and that's the reason it's very efficient and lasts a very long time. And of course, the Nc700, the engine. So if you're looking at this engine, it like faces up at an angle like this, but the NC actually like goes forward quite a bit. So if this is the front, like it's facing this way, so towards the front of the engine. And they put this engine on several bikes, including a cruiser sort of bike. I forgot the name of it, but it's a very docile bike. The engine makes such power down low. It's torquey, it's got like plenty of power, but it never feels like it's a lot of power. And it just revs really, really slow. The CB revs much faster. It feels like a peppier engine, and it is peppier. It just feels like a race bike compared to the NC. But I like the Nc700 much more for keeping in the long term. than I do the CB. And the reason is that to do maintenance on the NC is so much easier than the CB. Everything about the NC says I'm a home mechanic, I can fix it very simply. The valve adjustments on it still use the older style with the lock and the nut and the bolt as opposed to the CB. I really like that you don't have to pull the gas tank off the NC because the gas tank doesn't exist on the NC. And that's another thing, because of the different engine of the NC, there is no gas tank, so it's got this really large frunk. And at first I thought it was a gimmick, and it seems like very gimmicky. But when you ride it, you do realize that that frunk is just so useful. And you can put a full-size helmet inside that frunk. And it's amazing. If you're a commuter, that's all you need. You don't need to put this grotesque bag in the back of your motorcycle because it always looks good to have that gas tank looking thing. So when it comes to a commuter bike, both of these bikes are great, but of course the Nc700 is the commuter bike that you want. It is just simply one of the better commuters I've had. If you get it with the DCT, that means that you don't have to stop and go and constantly be shifting. It's quite an interesting thing. But the DCT versions of the NC are very expensive and hard to get. And at first, before I bought my Vishram 650, I actually wanted an Nc700 because I thought it would be a little bit better for me. The Cb500, I rode one cross country, and it's pretty decent. It doesn't have a lot of wind protection. It feels like a better dirt bike than the NC just because of the way it makes power. And I think you'd have a little bit more fun with the CB. The one I had ABS, and riding in the dirt wasn't that fun with ABS. This one also has ABS and you can't turn it off. I do wish that they made bikes that you could turn off the ABS, because riding an ABS bike in the dirt is kind of a pain and it's just kind of like scary to ride. And the new CBs though are much better for riding in the dirt than the NC, just because of the 19-inch front wheel. When you have a 19-inch front wheel, it just makes much more sense to ride off-road. The Vishram and this one both have 19-inch front wheels, and I'm much more comfortable riding those off-road than any bike with 17-inch front wheels. The Nc700, I believe, were about $6,500 brand new. But in the used marketplace, I've seen NCs go from $3,000 at the very low end to $4,500 for the newer versions, or the older versions of the NC. For the CB500, I've seen the prices drop quite a bit for the earlier ones because of the 19-inch front wheel coming on later. So I've seen prices from anywhere from $2,500 to $3,500. And because there's many more CB500s, I think you can get a much better deal on the CB500. And I think it's got a better resale than the NC to most people. At least it's going to be easier to sell. The NC is kind of a niche bike, and not a lot of people even know about it because they didn't sell many. So if you're going to be selling that bike after a year, there's not going to be that many people that know about that bike, because you know, most people only know the standard bikes. You know, they're looking for GSs, they're looking for Africa Twins, they're looking for Tenray, especially the Tenray 700. So the name Nc700 doesn't really come up very much, and more people are going to be into the CB. That's an established brand. So I think resale in the long term, even though the prices are lower, the CB is going to edge out the NC, and you should be able to sell the CB much easier than the NC. One thing that the CB has over the NC is that it's got a much bigger gas tank. 4.6 as opposed to 3.7. Now, on the NC, one of the things that they did that's kind of clever is they put the gas tank in the rear seat, and it goes underneath, so the filler is in the rear seat, and it keeps the weight really down low. And you do notice it while riding that the weight is very down low, and that's good. But if you're like me and you like to take road trips, you know, go to California from DC and stuff, the problem is that that under seat filler is a pain, because if you can see here, I have my bag on my seat, and if I do any sort of riding, I do strap stuff onto that rear seat. But you can't do that with a NC, because you have to constantly be opening up that rear seat to fill it. And it might be a small complaint, but Honda should have taken a cue from BMW. And I'm not a fan of BMW, but the BMW F series, they have a gas filler in the back and uses the same concept, except it's off to the side. They could have done that. That would have been a much better way of solving the problem of having, and you wouldn't have to open up the seat when you're filling, and you could use that seat as a cargo carrier. I think they missed out on that, but I do like the idea that everything is nice and streamlined on the NC, and I like the concept. I like the concept of the NC. Everything about it is very well done, and I do appreciate it. I mean, just the frunk space alone makes that bike a great idea for most people. And the battery is like in that frunk space as well. So one of the things I would do is maybe put a lithium battery there, because it is a little bit higher up. And having that battery in the frunk, it's easier to route cables to the handlebars for a GPS, for example, for a phone. It's a beautiful concept. I really appreciate that by Honda. The gas filler should have been off to the side. The budget, the suspension on both bikes is pretty budget. It's pretty much the same. This one, that's the thing, when you upgrade to one of the bigger bikes like this, the suspension gets much better. So if you were to ride this thing, it is just so much better than the CB and the NC. But that's to be expected. The NC and the CB are a different budget, different starting point for riders. And because of the CB has got such a high following, because you can get rally raid kits for it. So let's say if you bought a CB now and you're like, oh man, this bike sucks off-road, you can get a Africa Twin, like a baby Africa Twin kit, and that's going to make it a much better bike, better suspension, better wheels and everything. So the CB edges out the NC with aftermarket. The ride style of bikes are so different from bike to bike. Another thing I should mention before I get into the ride quality is that the CB has got a bigger gas tank, and this NC has got a smaller gas tank. But they get similar gas mileages. The NC gets better gas mileage because it revs lower, and it's that type of bike. It gets scooter-like mileage for a bike that's a 700cc bike, and that's kind of incredible all in its own. Now, ride quality. This is the part that I think the CB will give you a better ride quality if you're into spirited riding. It revs kind of quick, but I think that's what you want in a bike if you take it to the twisties and stuff. The CB riding quality is much better than the NC. The NC is really more like a scooter engine on a motorcycle that you use for commuting. But to me, I don't mind that, because I really like efficiency in motorcycles. And the NC is probably one of the most efficient motorcycles I've seen. I have a scooter, an SH150, and I find it amazing that with a 150cc engine, I get the same gas mileage that I got in the Nc700. And that's really incredible. Now the CB, I think you're going to be a faster rider on the CB. The NC, it feels like a chore riding in the twisty, especially if you're trying to keep up with any other bike. It's just always revving out, and it's easy to ride. All of these bikes for a new rider are very easy to ride bikes. This one, I don't recommend this for a new rider because it's too heavy, and that's pretty much it, because you can limit the power on it to a touring mode, but it's so big and heavy, and I think the CB and the NC make much better bikes for beginners. And even though I think the CB is a better bike, more fun to ride, I think I would actually buy the NC, because I really appreciate Honda's concept on this, and it makes a lot of sense for everyday riders. And I think when you couple it with ultra good reliability and ease of use and ease of maintenance at home, I think the NC edges out the CB. But if you're a type of rider that wants to ride off-road, the CB is going to be a much better bike for you, and it's got way more peppiness than the NC. All right, guys, thanks for watching. That is a little bit of a comparison between the NC and the CB. Both of these bikes are extremely good. You can't go wrong with any of them, but there's definitely some personality types that are going to be aiming towards one as opposed to the other. Just get what you want, because both of these bikes are great and they're going to give you many years of reliable service. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video. Like me.